All right. Letter live. Final Fantasy XIV 75.
Letter live. Yeah. Final Fantasy 75 of S14.
Yes. All right. Here's the trailer.
Here we go. This is what I'm looking for.
Square
Enix presents in 4K. Business creative business creative business. Number 3.
Okay, so we're starting off with the 12 stuff.
Yep. Ooh, that's bitty.
Huh.
There you go. Yeah, it's okay. Earth and water. We're gonna see Nafika, Manfina,
Halone.
No, that's ice. Halone is ice.
Oh, Halone is ice.
This is gonna be water and earth, because the last one was fire and lightning.
Oh, you're right, you're right, you're right. Oh, that's so pretty.
I know, I love. I'm actually really loving the look of this this dungeon.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll have to watch again in English.
Yo! Okay. Oh, is this the new deep dungeon? Oh, it's that model! We haven't seen that model in a long time.
I actually really love that demon model. That, not demon. I shouldn't call it a demon.
Void scent.
Yeah.
Back at the Crystal Tower, it looks like. Zero being a badass. Oh, expended too much aether. Vitra!
Oh, this looks so good!
You can see a little bit of a titty. Titty's confirmed. God. See, but that looks like
that
ice.
That is ice.
I'm so pretty sure it's...
Are we doing ice and earth, maybe?
Maybe. I would have to see the way the symbols are placed on the thing. Godbert!
I'm sorry, did Godbert just do mechanics in a fight?
Probably. Why are we DJing? Okay.
Yo, I'm ready for this.
Map.
Yeah. Hold on, what are those minions moving down the maps?
Yeah, bro, I think we might be doing earth and ice. That's Halone.
That is Halone.
That is absolutely
Halone. That is 100% Halone. She looks so good. Manfina is ice? Oh, shit. I thought she was water for some reason.
So, yeah, I think it's earth and ice.
It's going to be earth and ice then. Which still goes in line with what we said.
Wind it's going is gonna around Guile. Wind is going to be last, yeah.
Yeah, it's earth and ice, yeah.
New ultimate? I mean, we already
knew
this
was
coming.
Oh, yeah, we knew this was happening.
Does that mean the chick with the blue hair is Manfina?
Wow, did they update their models for this?
It looks like it.
It looks like they did.
I'm gonna be a little whelmed if the chick with blue hair is Manfina. All right, Gods, Revel, Lands, Treble.
I'm honestly really excited for this.
Yeah, me too.
Thing.
I want to learn more about the 12, I really do.
Yeah. Hi, Aristotle.
Also, hi, Aristotle, how you doing?
I don't think it's going to be Ashan. Ashan will be last, because my prediction is Ashan is actually the guy with the monkey, with the Oppo with us right now. I think that's actually Ashan. So, yeah, we're going to show the trailer again.
We're going to look at the trailer again. Okay, let's see. A more critical eye.
Now they're commenting over it. They said you can follow along in the end, but I'm fine just watching. So we're going to watch it later on anyway.
Yeah.
We have a chance to actually really, really look at this in detail. So, obviously Earth, this is Althic and Nafika. Actually makes sense.
So yeah, I think we're seeing more of the 12, because there's that one.
Yeah, there, right there. Yeah. We saw it. Right there, the guy on the right, it's Althic. That is 100% Althic.
There's one called the Spinner, I think. Who's the Spinner?
I think she's the other wind one. Or I think she's the other wind one. Let me see here real fast.
But there were definitely Nimia. Okay.
Yeah. Oh, she's water.
I am so excited. I am so excited for this dungeon because Snowcloak, that's one of my favorite dungeons in the game. Like, I love the winter stuff. This is interesting. Right here, like, all these, like, armors coming alive and attacking this dude.
Well, they have explained that all these patches are leading into the next story.
Yeah.
So we are, I almost think 100% you might have called it. It's going to do something with the 13, with the 13th shard.
Yeah. I think it's definitely going to have something to do with the 13th shard. And then I think when 7.0 starts, I think that's where all new players are going to start from, is 7.0.
Yeah. No, I think the same thing. I think that's going to be the new starting point for the game. They're going to be like, you can either start at 2.0 or you can start at 7.0. And that's what people are. So that's Nafaga right there. She is known for wielding a scythe.
Yeah, I mean, she looks almost exactly like the Twin Adders.
Artwork. Yeah, she, which is great.
Yeah, and this actually is obviously Halone. There's two moons there,
Halone,
by the way.
Yeah, and Manfina.
Manfina.
All I think is going to be the end of the dungeon, I think.
Ascian Prime. That might have something to do with the ultimate, maybe? No, that might have something to do with the deep dungeon. I don't understand why we're having a rave party, but okay.
I cannot wait for this arena.
I know.
It looks so good.
Yeah, that's definitely Minfina. She's got the wolf. And that's absolutely Halone. That looks like the statue from
I can't tell. So here's the thing. My thought is, since they didn't really show much of Althic, that is why I think he's going to be the last one. They tend to do that where they don't show a lot.
Yeah.
But she has this cool animation thing she's doing. So she may be the last one, you know? Or they might just go ham on them.
Yeah. I mean, it almost looked like Minfina and Halone, or Halone. I keep saying Halone because I'm dumb. It almost looked like Minfina and Halone were doing a dual attack, unless that was Minfina and a wolf.
That orb thing when they went to the carriers, I actually don't think that's either of them. I think that might be Althic.
Okay.
Doing something.
It made me think of Nalthal. Halone is... Oh! Halone is the correct pronunciation. Okay.
Have we actually heard them pronounce it? Do they have like an actual...
That's how Ishgardians...
Oh, that's how the Ishgardians actually in MCQ say it? Oh, shit.
Yeah. Either way, I'm hyped for this. All right, so what's to come in patch 6.3? The MSQ, new side quest, the Endeavor continues. That's something I need to do. Tales of the Newfound Adventure... Also something else I need to do, and somehow, further Hildebrandt Adventures. Also something that I need to do. I'm behind, y'all.
But that somehow further won't come until 6.35.
Yeah, so I got time.
In.
Oh, okay, so we're getting further Manderville weapons, then we're getting the Loperitz, which I think we knew that already. I'm pretty sure that was announced, like, back during FanFest when they were first announcing Endwalker.
Oh, shit, you're gonna have to complete name that way.
Oh, I mean, we've at least started it because we had the air currents, but we'll get there.
I should level up my crafter, my single
Your single crafter.
Holy shit, that would explain the DJ and stuff. There you go, Lily.
Yeah, this is probably like the entertainment area.
Yes. We're probably going to help them build a place that's like more entertaining so people can visit or at least they'll have more fun. I don't know.
Well, it's probably in a similar vein as the dungeon that they made because like the whole lore behind the Excitatron 9000 is that it was meant to be a form of entertainment for when people came to go on the space journey to find a new homeworld. New trials and a new Unreal trial. I'm... torn on this with
FYI,
Sophia.
Actually, you can use Zero in this duty support as well.
No shit. That's actually really cool.
Yeah. The new trial will stay a secret. We couldn't use it for marketing. We couldn't use it for the trailer either. Seriously?
It's probably something story related. And they don't want to reveal it because it's...
it's we know what it's going to be. It's just going to be the next...
Maybe it's not. Maybe it's not going to be the next Elemental Fiends. Maybe you're...
Lies and slander.
I don't know, dude.
Well, we've got 6.3.
Yeah.
6.4.
Yeah.
6.5.
So 6.5 is probably going to be Golbez.
Yeah, but that means you have to fill it in with two things, right?
Right.
I'm assuming we're going to do Fire, Water, then Golbez, or...
Or we get a dual trial with both of them.
Yes, then we're going to get Golbez, and then we're going to get the thing that behind Golbez.
Yeah.
Which, if I remember correctly, I think Golbez is not the... I can't remember. Oh, God, it's been so long.
I've never played Final Fantasy IV, so I don't know.
Euphrosyne. The Phantom Realm. Euphrosyne. I don't know how that's actually pronounced it, but yeah,
I don't,
this is 100% this I'm looking forward to, and this is what I'm going to be doing day one. I want to do, I want the 12 lore so bad.
Yeah.
I want to know.
I mean, since freaking...
They've been there since the beginning, dude. Since the beginning.
Do
you remember? Actually, you may not know, remember this. Actually, I don't remember if it carried over to 2.0, but I remember when you chose... your who you were a follower of, it actually would affect your elemental resistance.
Yes, I do remember that.
That was, I honestly thought that was the funniest thing. It never did anything.
Oh, it's the Omega Protocol. We're so surprised.
Surprised, yes.
Ooh, this is my surprise face. Hold on, guys. I'm so surprised. It's the Omega Protocol. So, Deep Dungeon. We've got the Deep Dungeon coming here. And that's
Eureka
the...
Orthos.
Yeah, and it's elegant in nature.
Which is interesting, but not unexpected. Yeah.
I think I recall in an interview that was just released, Yoshi-P was saying that they didn't go too extremely heavy on the story elements, but that there is like a nice little story.
The, the it's only gonna, the first 30 floors are story. Everything after that is everything after that is just gonna be for funsies.
Yeah, and then it's probably gonna be 100 floors because they mentioned Heaven on High. Like a lot of people had said that Heaven on High is like the perfect level of difficulty for this stuff.
Yeah.
Hey, they're continuing doing the solo stuff, making it so that you can solo the game.
I'm not surprised. They've been wanting to do this. They want to make 14 a single player game. And to some extent,
to
right?
Some extent, to some extent, yeah. The old stuff. They want you to be able to go through and play the old stuff single.
They want the storyline experience to be a single player thing. Like, yeah. You can do by yourself. You don't need to make friends. You can literally buy Final Fantasy 14, play through the story.
Yeah.
That's what they want.
And I'm okay with that because honestly, the story is so good. I feel like people who don't play Final Fantasy 14 because they're intimidated by the social aspect or the backlog of stuff to go through, or even not even just intimidated, but just don't like the social aspect. Like there's some people who are just like, I don't like people. So we have job adjustments coming.
What a
PvP updates. Another PvP series where I will not get Crystal.
I'm really frustrated because I know when those job adjustments drop, they're not going to do anything for Samurai, and I kind of just wish, like, I want to see a small buff. All I want to see is a teeny buff. Just a teeny buff.
How about making it so that you don't have more casts in Summoner? How about that?
You know what I'd love to see, honest to God? I'd love to see just Ogi not have a cast. Just take off cast on Ogi, and I'd be like, that's great. That's fine. Their update for PvP will be no more cast on Samurai. I'd be like, that's just fine.
Ooh, crafting and gathering updates. Oh no, they're doing relics for crafting and gathering. Shit, no, I don't wanna. No, don't make me do it. I have to. I gotta get them all. Oh, I hate this. Oh, primary fishing locations, preferred bait, and additional conditions will be added to the fish guide. That is awesome.
I am glad, honestly, the bottom area is the most important one. I'm glad that they're showing up like more locations that you can actually go diving into and swim.
Yeah, I hope they go add more areas. Like, I won't lie, I completely forget that spearfishing and diving is a thing. Like, there are tons of places in Shadowbringers and Endwalker that you can go underwater, but I've never gone underwater because I forget it's a thing.
Island Sanctuary, new sanctuary ranks and visions, new items, new materials, new structures, improved workshop interface.
This basically expanding on everything that we enjoy. I got my Island Sanctuary to level 10 and then I stopped. Like, my animals are probably dead. I have like no gathering items. I haven't really bought all the stuff. I got the motorcycle and I was like, okay.
What they need to do right now though is I need to see if they were smart and they said, oh, by the way, you can now collect all the yields and all the items and one button press now.
Oh, like quick gathering?
Yeah,
quick gathering in there.
Where
yeah.
Just auto collects all of them because I have to go through when I'm collecting and
spam the button.
Spam it over yeah. And over and over. And it sucks.
It's like what collecting used to be.
Yeah, it sucks. I actually need to go back in there and see if they've eaten all the food. I haven't been in there for like weeks.
Am I dumb? I feel like they did have quick gathering in the Island Sanctuary.
No, they did not. You have to go through down each item. So if you have like them auto collecting for you, you have to go down and click on each one to collect for them.
Oh, you're talking about
the caretakers.
Oh, okay. You're talking about the caretakers. Got it. No, I think they did say they added that. I'm pretty sure they said they added that.
They didn't show it in the last slide. If they don't show it in one of these slides, I'm gonna be upset. That's the one thing I really hate doing. I'm so bloody casual about it, right? I've been just doing stuff, been following items to be putting
guides
in there.
Guides and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, there's like a guide that they do weekly.
Hey!
Option to collect all available yields, leaves at once. There you go.
There you go.
There you go. Oh, island visitors now hear the isle keepers orchestration. Well, that's good. Oh, and a notification when visitors arrive.
Yeah, I like that.
So, you know,
like
they don't walk in on you as you're ERPing.
extreme rate progressioning.
Yeah.
Oh, so we're getting a treasure hunt update, and it's going to be the shifting altars type, which is the one I'm really excited for.
Nice.
That is honestly my favorite one. I need to go back to doing some of the treasure hunt because
we should do some of that one of these days.
I mean, there's a lot of good shit you can get from the treasure map.
I think the problem is that, like, I don't really like the one where you just choose one of the doors and then you go down the road and then it's just like another, like, it's just another big AoE mob fight. And so it's really hard for me to want to do it because they have that type and it really, it's kind of boring to me. This one right here, the shifting Gymnasium Agonon is the other one, and that's the one that I'll like.
Yeah, that'll have the roulette altars and stuff like that.
Because those are fun to me because first off, they're quick and easy. They don't take like tons of time to go through, but they always give you like cool, like mini boss battles and stuff. And so the fights are never boring affairs. You have to do a little bit of work.
Yeah. And then they're trickling in more housing as usual.
Yep. Not surprised.
It will do nothing for Balmong. They'll all be gone in like 5 minutes. Oh, I forgot there's a lottery system now, but they will still all be gone.
Apparently, servers you see on the list will not get more plots because there are still empty ones left.
That makes sense. And especially for Dynamis as well. It's the brand. I think Materia is new as well.
Yeah. So there's empty plots on all of these still. Yes, the icons for damage. Thank God.
UI update.
And then displaying timers on
your
party.
Yes, that's going to be so awesome.
God. This helps you find out right away whether you should be fainting something, addling something.
Yeah.
I mean, Reprisal doesn't care because Reprisal just does it for everything.
Same thing with Troubadour.
Yeah.
I'm so thankful that Troubadour is just a catch-all because I don't think my tiny brain could handle.
Seeing the timers, there are too many times I've looked at the timers on my allies. I've looked up to see the timers, like how long is something going to last on them? And I remember, oh, they don't have a timer list, so I can't be using them.
Okay, so miscellaneous updates.
Alternate UI theme, clear blue.
Portraits and duty finder.
Yes!
I'm excited for that.
Expansion of available activities while using fashion accessories. Yeah.
I hope mounting is one of them.
They will not add them. I might have, so apparently
I know we've talked about this already.
The expansion of available activities might have been taken as adding new myths using the during the use of the fashion accessories, but it is things like using a mount while having an umbrella out, and once you get off the mount, it will automatically use the umbrella again.
I'm not gonna lie, I had a hard time following what you said because
what he stated was that there are certain emotes that if you have an accessory, fashion accessory out, will now keep it out. But if you're on a mount, it's going to make it disappear, and then once you get off the mount, it'll reappear again.
I'm okay with that.
They did state there is also a new feature that if it starts to rain, you can automatically have the fashion accessory come out and it'll bring out an umbrella for you.
Oh, that's awesome.
There was one adjustment you'd want to see for Bard Lily. What would it be? One realistic one, not like the dream, an actual realistic adjustment.
One realistic adjustment for Bard.
Yeah, not like I like to make a ranger. Like
no,
that.
I know.
Not an adjustment that is like a complete overhaul.
I think what I would want is for Apex Arrow to not suck so much. Like Apex Arrow and Burst Arrow. Those are, bear in mind that is our capstone ability for level 80 and level 9 is Apex Arrow and Burst Arrow. I only get to fucking use that ability once every 2 minutes. Because even if it fills up while you're halfway through Mage's Ballad, it is better to release it when you're back into Wanderer's Minuet and have all of your buffs up. It sucks.
Here we go, job adjustments. Oh, look at that gear, dude.
Job. Oh,
yo,
that
scythe
really
looks
cool.
Rad. Vivimillion deal burst damage by adjusting action efficiency and rotations. Oh, this is for a paladin. Okay, I was like, excuse me. This is not surprising. Improving your versatility by decreasing reliance on damage over time. I don't know if that was ever really a problem, was it? Unless this is just a weird. I don't know what they mean by that. That's what I'm gonna say. I don't know what it means by that. I do know. How many dots do they have? They only have like 2 dots, right?
For Bard?
No, for Paladin.
Oh, I don't know.
I thought they only had 2 dots. Oh, is there just a lot of damage on the dots? What's the potency on their fucking dots? What is the potency and time on their dots? Good God. Improving usability of certain defensive skills? I feel like this is going to be talking about cover and whatnot. Biggest problem with Paladin right now is it's a better OT than it is an MT, and that feels so weird. From a thematic standpoint, like it's not, if you don't care about that at all, then it's fine. But I've always thought it was just really weird that Paladin's a better OT than an MT. But when you've got things like cover, you buff, you're gonna ally, to reduce the damage and whatnot, stuff like that. And they've got a lot of abilities to do that. Rotation has been shortened to accommodate high power actions. Okay, that makes sense. That'll help with the burst. Okay, so the impact of dot damage for them was too high, so they just have very high dot damage. Goring Blade and Blade of Valor have lost their dots. Divine Might is now applied after weapon skill combos, allowing Enhanced Holy Spirit to be executed once without casting. Holy Shelter's effects have changed, reduced damage taken, thereby enhancing defensive capabilities against damage over time. Okay, that makes sense. So it's not like the next attack. Their previously removed Bulwark ability has been revamped and reintroduced. This is the first time they've reintroduced a removed ability. What the fuck? This map. Oh, this map, dude.
Really good.
Yo. Ninja doors? Are you serious? Oh my god! Yeah, Shouha sucked when Shadowbringers first dropped. Shouha was a laugh. Yo, that's so fucking cool! Wait, why are those floors?
Yeah, why are those glowing?
What?
Oh shit, so that's the the terrain.
You can't stay on it. You can't do that. It'll flip up. There's so many gimmicks here.
Oh, this is gonna be their gimmick map.
Whoa! That's a lot of damage. What the fuck? Yo, that's a lot of. Oh, shield doesn't work. He might have done it too late. That might have been too late. Yo, I'm loving the gimmicks. The ninja door was awesome.
Stun is going to be very strong here.
Oh, stun is going to be dangerously good here. As is binding people. Holy shit, this is going to be so good for samurai and ninja.
Oh, look, it turned into twilight. Oh, this is cool.
Is there gonna be gold on the ground one? Oh my god, the bitmate. Whoa! What are these guys? What do they do?
Oh!
Oh, it just kills you?
Holy shit! Oh, this map is is gonna be crazy!
Yo!
This is gonna be crazy!
Pick up the money! I wanna see him pick up the money!
Get the money, what's the money do? Yoshi!
Yoshi! Show me!
Show me!
I wanna see the money!
Money, money, money!
That was so fucking cool!
That was cool!
Holy shit, the gimmicks in this are gonna be- Oh, people hate this- everybody's gonna hate this one. There's so many people that are gonna hate this fucking map, and I'm gonna be like, this is the best map ever.
Yoshi, take the money!
Grab the money!
Grab the money!
Stop!
I wanna see the money!
Grab the money!
Take the money!
Don't get killed again!
Yoshi!
Oh, does he go for the guard? No, it doesn't. Okay. Wow!
Okay, Yoshi, what's the money do?
Grab the money, grab the money.
What are you doing?
What is he doing? Oh, he's Yoshi. Taking the, I don't know what he's doing. What does the money do? It's some sort of gimmick.
Where's the money even show up on his bar?
It doesn't, I don't see showing up anywhere. Yeah, where's the money show up? It'd be really funny if it actually gave you gil.
Right? I'm almost looking at his gil to see.
What is this for? This is for some new gimmick mechanic. Oh, he's capped out. Where's the cap though? He only picked up like five.
Yeah, I don't see it.
I'm not seeing anything in the UI. What does the money do?
Tessa said, what if the getting the money is like paying the Yojimbo puppets so they don't hurt you?
That would be interesting.
This really does look
I really want to know what the money does. Tell me. I want to know. I love this.
Dude.
I love that so much.
That is so cool.
That is so fucking cool. But this means now that they can actually put in, I know it's a game thing, but it also means lore-wise it is technically possible for them to actually apply teleportation to areas and whatnot. Which isn't unheard of, but it's so funny. Okay, wait, so now they're doing something new. It's another event thing. No! What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Go back!
Come back!
No!
No! Alright, so here is the new Alliance raid. So here we are inside of the new Alliance area.
This looks so good. I can't believe they made Windows XP look so good in the year 2022/2023. It's amazing how good Windows XP looks right now.
I know, it's great.
It's an odd choice to have made it golden. It was green, but I'm, you know, I like the golden fields, you know. Wait, there's three treasure chests over there.
I do not trust.
What is this? Did they just kill the boss already?
What is this?
The boss is already dead.
Yoshi, what did you do?
The boss is already dead.
Who's that?
That's Graha.
Is it Graha?
It's Graha, I think. They're fields of wheat for sure. It's gotta be fields of wheat.
Yeah. This is hitting, so like, just as much as I love like snowy areas,
the whole
golden wheat fields, that hits.
I agree. Golden wheat fields are so good. Yeah. I love how they look.
No, that is not the guy from the quest because he's got a tail.
He's
that
got a tail. That's definitely Graha.
Oh, damn it, Quinn.
Shut what's the happening? Fuck up, Quinn.
Fucking Quinn.
Fuck off, dude. That was a good bait switch. I give you props for that, Quinn. That was really solid. Damn it, that was good.
Okay, so we got toads. Really? We're the fucking warriors of light. We have traveled across time and space, and we're still fighting toads. I'm so sick of this shit. Like, I really do get annoyed when I see like basic bitch enemy models. Like, I get it. They're always gonna recycle models, but there are times where it's like, I am a fucking level 90 warrior of light. Why am I still fighting a bird that spits a fish on me?
I do. That is the only thing I've always. Wow, Graha.
You're such a nerd.
He's such a nerdy dude. I love it. He's a bundle of joy.
You're saying that is the one thing, what, meta?
I just that it's always been the one thing that always really got me, like when you get to end game content and they still throw like the fucking, you like face a level 10 seagull in the beginning of the game and then you get to the end and it's like, it's the same seagull model and everything. It doesn't even do anything special. And it's just like, it's a level 100 seagull. I'm like, what the fuck? If you're going to throw those models at me, I need you to have some changes to them. I want that seagull to be like that meme. It's like when you see a level 100 seagull, I want it to like immediately snap its head towards you and it's eyes blare red. I want that to be. If that seagull's level 100, that seagull butt is like pulling out a ripped axe. I want that seagull to like puff out and suddenly he's got like a six pack on a six pack seagull. That's what I want to see. I want him to go, oh god.
I want that seagull to be shredded. I want that seagull to have an eight pack.
Yep.
Nobody was surprised.
I mean, the trailer told us already, but we knew this is going to come for the next ultimate.
I'm excited for it regardless.
They did say, by the way, there's not going to be another ultimate after this.
Yeah.
Not surprised. I am not surprised.
I'm not surprised. They have profusely apologized for skipping an ultimate, but they have always made it clear that they just aren't sure if they were going to be able to make up for it. And I get it. I feel like DSR kind of made up for the lack of a second ultimate because it was so good, both like mechanically and story-wise.
Hell, even viewership-wise, it's really fun to watch. Apparently, this is going to be an interesting fight because we start with Omega from the start.
So now we're talking about the new treasure map that Meta's really excited for.
Yes, I am excited for this treasure map.
Come on, you know that I mean in the sense that you like it better than the other treasure map.
It's super great and awesome. They are fun. The problem is we get poor attendance on them. People just didn't want to do them. To be fair, they're really mind-numbing. It's why I like this one better than the other one. The other one is really mind-numbing. This one is at least fun.
After these maps come out, I don't mind gathering some and seeing if we can get like more attendance up again.
Yeah. I'm not gonna lie, I kind of like the blue UI.
The blue one?
Yeah, I'm really kind of liking the new UI that they're using in this right now. Because it really reminds me of like the traditional like Final Fantasy 7 and 8 and whatnot. I'm really enjoying it.
It's very slick.
Yeah, it just reminds me a lot of 7, honestly. Not so much 8. 8 was great. See, that's what I'm talking about. You get a cool boss fight, and then you do the boss fight, right? And they're gonna get like a boss fight here. You do the boss fight. He just instant killed it. You cheater! What we got next? Deep dungeon! Let's see here. Players must first complete the scenario, must be level 81 or higher. It's everything like a regular deep dungeon. Yep. Honestly, the folks who have gone out of their way to get Necromancer in Deep Dungeon, I like applaud them. I wish I could get the Necromancer title. I don't know if I have that time though to go through Deep Dungeon and learn it.
Oh, look at the little imps. Little imps.
Death claws.
I mean, Alligan and Void Scent, they go hand in hand.
Ashkin, Void Scent, Alligan Constructs. Why is it that whenever Alligans show up, there's always the undead and Void Scent right behind them?
Let's see, because they made a pack with the most powerful Void Scent in the, you know, history of Void Scent.
Might have something to do with it. It's interesting to see that they've turned into a Machina now. I like that. That's cool. Is he going to shoot them with something? Yes, he is. Choo! Oh! It's like the Succubus. It has a stacking dot. Oh, he just punched that man to death. Oh, he punched that man to death. I'm liking this already. I'm liking this machine you can turn into. Almost died. That's one of the Demiclones. What does this do? Show us. He just follows you. Okay? He just follow you for the floor? Oh, he also attacks and shit. Oh, he's like a party member. Yo, that's really freaking cool. Does he just stay there for the whole map then? Oh, shit. Yes, he stays there for the map. And then he's gonna disappear on this one, I bet. Let's see here. That'd be really cool. Yeah, okay, they're gone. They stay for the map though, because I didn't see any countdown timer on that at all. Hold on, let's do something really quickly here. Because I want to go see the 4K version of the new Final Fantasy patch. Hold on. Peggy 16. Boop.
Peggy 16.
Here we go. I want to make sure it's on. Wait, hold on a second. Let me make sure it's full volume. Settings. 1080, absolutely. Oh no, they don't have it on 4K yet. Damn it.
At last, the time has come.
Hold on, before we continue on here real fast, just to be sure, I'm going to go check and see if they have the 4K version of it at all, by any chance. It was 8 hours ago when they dropped this bad boy. HD. Yeah, unfortunately, the 4K version is just not up yet. That sucks. Okay, well, we'll deal.
Long have I awaited this moment.
Bear to me your lover's heart. Have you the strength to defy fate?
I, the Fury, shall test your strength of spirit.
It might be. They stream at 1080. You can stream at 1080 on Twitch. It's good to see you again.
But enough about events here.
But I do agree, yeah, the compression is pretty rough.
And with new company besides. The 13th. I thought you'd keep your escapades closer to home for a while.
Oh, I've been waiting so long. Don't disappoint.
How big must the gate be for their light to come through? Too weak. Help me. Someone. Please.
He's calling.
So gorgeous.
You. What have you done to Asdaya?
That world will never be ours again. We need not suffer in this purgatory of death and rebirth forever.
Deluge of ether. The mark of a terrible magic.
Gosh damn it, why is Halon so cool?
Join me, and together we shall seek the promised land. A glorious kingdom of light, wherein all may know death's sweet embrace.
Oh,
The orchestra version of that song is going to be amazing. Oh, damn, dude. All right, so let's go. Let's actually look over this a little bit. Hold on. Let's shut it up for a moment. We're going to actually look over this a little bit because I want to go over some of the scenes here since we get to see some cool stuff here. So let's see here. Let's go here. I'm going to give a shit about you. Here we go. Let's see here. So we've got explosions going outwards, my guys. Look at that shit. Damn, dude. So we got some cool stuff. Gobaz. What is this? Seriously, what is this? It's a four-man fight. Is this just a revamping of the dungeon, I think? Oh, I forgot this is here. Holy shit, he's just dodging everything. This is probably from the new... Oh, no, this is also from a four-man, because it's got those guys there. That's the... We've already seen that. Yeah, it's going to be the revamped version of the Aetherochem. We've seen this stuff. I want to see more of the 24-man. Yes, okay, here we go. This is what I was looking forward to. We'll go back. We'll start from the start on, and this is going to take 5 seconds to get there. So you've got her loyal wolf, Dalamon. Look at this. It's on a checkerboard map. Damn, dude, this looks good. So it's either going to be all thick at the end, or it's going to be Halone at the end. But they barely showed anything of all thick. So I'm not sure what direction they're going to go with this. Oh, yeah, you're right. That was Calabrina. It could be the updated Z-Super. You're 100% right. Yeah, I totally forgot. She moves over to the side. He's going to perform a mechanic, it looks like. Yo, that looks cool. It looks like almost all of the 12 are going to have some really cool, like, spectacular limit break effects going off here, because this looks amazing. Halone getting a badass sword. Jesus Christ, dude. What the fuck is this? And then she brings the weapon down. It slots out. So this has got to be all thick right here, I think. So we can see here, here's the player characters, but we've got the horsey, a horsey right here, and we've got somebody else right here. Let me see here. We've got the 12 up. So all thick, let's see, we've got Nofika. We've seen her. Halone, Menfina. This has got to be all thick. It has to be. Because it's also space and time clearly coming into play here. And that's obviously Halone. I love the fact that she's using a spear and shield in this shit. It's really cool. More Golbez. And then this is the ending of it. Yeah. Damn, dude. There's like a lot of interesting things going on in here. I'm trying to find if there's anything else. All right, we need to actually get this scene. Let's go over here. So there we've got... Not Nofika. Menfina, I think. All right, here's something that's really weird. Who the fuck is this? Who the fuck is that? This has to be Althic. This has to be Althic. Because Althic is associated with the Great Axe. So this must be him. But who the fuck is this? It does look like Galaxy Stop. I don't know who this son of a bitch is. And does it fade out more? And stop, we can see... Oh, hold on. Hold on. Halone is right here, and then we've got... Oh, you're right. The spinner. You're right. Not Menfina. Yes, Menfina. No, not Menfina. Yes. No. Nimia. There you go. I had to think about that for a second. So we've got... Nofika's right here. We have, I'm guessing, Althic right here. It's got to be Althic. So Nimia is right here then. Halone is right here. And then there's Menfina right here. why is... The question is, if Nimia is showing up, why is... It is... It looks like it's a female. She is depicted as a weaver donning a white silken veil. Okay, so this has to be her. This is Nimia for sure. That is 1000% Nimia. Is the horn? I don't know. The horn's not so much. This guy is all thick. This is 100% all thick. So this is Halone. This is Nafika, Menfina, Nimia, all thick. I don't know why Nimia is here though, but there are five. We can see that there's five because it's fading out, right? It's fading out into dankness. But we definitely can see right here. Yeah, we can definitely see that there's other characters here that are them. So yeah, we've got five with us this try time. There are five of us with this right now. So right, just to go over. Yeah, it's 100% him. He's got the great axe. Althic is depicted wielding a mithril great axe. Nimia has a white veil. This would be, we've got Nafika on the side, Menfina is right here, and then we have Halone right here. Yeah, you can see the hair. It's Nafika. This is 100% Nafika. I think she was on the left. Yes, I think so, because that has to be Nimia, which means that Nimia might be doing something in the fights. Fuck, this is really cool. But the question then becomes, why is Nimia here? Right? Like, why is she here? This isn't your shebang. Get the hell out. Endwalker. The real question is if we're going to this zone first or if we're going the ice zone first. Halone is going to be the end or Althic is going to be the end. It might even be Althic and Nimia because we didn't see much of them. Actually, I'm going to put my money on it right now. Althic and Nimia are at the end. They are 1000% at the end because we haven't seen much about them, and they did that same. They've been doing that for a while now where they don't show the final boss. Maybe they do a combo fight so we have a non-12 boss at the very, very end next time. That's very possible. Yeah, Nimia and Althic are the parents of Menfina and Azemia. Yes. But if we fight them, then the question becomes, when we have the four fights next, who do we fight? Right? Or do they do like a, I don't have much to say on this. Like, it's a cool trailer scene moment. But I have, like, nothing to say on it because I have no idea what the hell's going on. It's cool to see that they're showing combat stuff, though. That's really cool. So, yeah. Yes, all of them would be awesome. Holy shit. The fourth fight, just doing all of them would be amazing. Give us a full-on Knights of the Round fight, even though we already have Knights of the Round. Yes, please. If Althic and Nimia both fight us in the last fight, then all we have left is Thaliak, Ashan, and Lumalin. Or Lumilane, however you say her name. That would leave the only last three gods left because there's nobody else. If we get a double, if Althic and Nimia fight us, then we'll have only three people left. Yeah, I think so too, Quinn, because it's definitely zero in the scene. But it all depends. It's all going to depend. I actually 100% say this. I'm going to say it again. I straight up think that the dude that we're traveling with is Ashan. The guy who has the Opo Opo, the little Opo Opo, baby Opo Opo. That's Ashan. I've said that since day one. I've said it since we started this thing. I even stated that the last tier is going to 100% be Wind. Wind is going to be the last one to show up because Ashan is going to be at the end. If we don't fight him, that would kind of be sad. It'd be really cool to fight all the 12. But it would be cool if he actually did fight along us. Because to be fair, the Warrior of Light reflects Ashan perhaps the most in all forms of capacity. Because the Warrior of Lights has traveled and wandered just about everywhere, and he continues to do so. If that's not Ashan, I don't know who is. This is so cool. Her whole arena, by the way, I want to point out here something. Check this shit out real fast. We're going to pause it real fast there. We're going to go back. Look at the beginning of this fight. Look at the background of the arena. It actually changes. When she does this, boom. Look at that shit. It's a completely different background now. Whoa! That's freaking rad. Oh, you can see the dragoons on the left here and whatnot. I love it. All right. I don't think there's much more to say on this shit. It's really, really cool. I think it's like really, really cool that we're getting like this stuff right here. I'm going to leave it on this scene because it's really cool. I'm really excited for 6.3. I'm mostly excited for the 12 content because there's a lot about the 12 and what they are and why they are and so on and so forth that we just don't know about. We know for a fact that they've got these phantom realms. We know for a fact that they claim to not be primals. They've been around way, way longer than that. They are aware of Heidelin. They are not bad. They're not bad people. They specifically state that they were just putting on a show because they wanted us to like engage with them. They have actively gone out of the way to hide themselves as much as possible from other people. But it's not always perfect. If there's instability in Aether in the world, they have shown up in some capacity. And they have had like religion based on them. They have even stated that when we were praying to them at the end of the 1.0 storyline, and Louis Soi used them to summon up the power, they straight up tell us that like that wasn't, we had nothing to do with that. Your prayers summoned a primal of some other thing or the like, we had nothing to do with with you doing praying and whatnot to save us from Bahamut. We had nothing to do with that. It's not us. Some other guy. So we really don't know much about them. We don't know exactly what role they play because a lot of the lore that we do know is all based on the unreliable narrator because all the lore that we know about them is essentially from the belief system that is very light, mind you, a very light belief system that is within the world of Eorzea in and of itself. So, yeah. We're not really sure what's exactly going on, what it involves, but it would be nice to know, why are they here? What actually are they? What are they doing around here now that Heidelin's gone? Why has their realm been able to be suddenly, you know, punctured into? That might be Ashan actually doing that purposely to get us over there. Why do they actively try to not take in any shape or form some sort of reaction to the world? Why do they not seem to like want to interfere with anything on in like how the planet's turning and tiding and whatnot? How, you know, what is their major goal for what they're doing? Like, why are they here? What are their goals in mind? We don't know anything about them. So I'm really hoping and praying, wishing upon a Holonic star that they will tell us something about them. But I'm not so sure because there was just an interview that was done earlier with Yoshi and he did state that there's going to be still a lot of questions coming out from even this tier, the second tier of the 12 storyline. And if that's the case, then my question really comes down to is that, like, how much is actually going to answer? Are they saving everything for the end? And I don't know. I want to know, but we just don't know.